Hi guys, this is Dia and welcome back to Mom and Me. So today we are going to explore five small kitchen appliances that I personally use in my kitchen, but I truly feel they are must have in any given kitchen. Actually, there are so many appliances out there. There's food processor, blender, juicer, slow cooker, rice cooker, and the list goes on. But I am going to show you five kitchen appliances that I feel are must have, and they will actually help you do most of your kitchen jobs. So let's get started with the video. But before we do that, guys, don't forget to hit the like button. I'm aiming for 5,000 likes. Do your bit and support this channel by hitting that like button. So let's just dive straight into the video, shall we? The first appliance we're going to cover is this little buddy hand blender. It has three components. One is the stainless steel arm that is used to blend dal, puree fruits or soups. Another component is this whisk, which I use to make frothy cold cocoa or mouth-watering chas or buttermilk. It comes with a jar as well, which you can use to whisk your drinks in. And finally, this chopper, which you can use as a small, very handy processor, food processor. And I use this for pretty much everything. To puree tomatoes for tomato gravy when I'm meal prepping over the weekends, to finely chop onion, garlic, ginger when I'm making Punjabi curries, or roughly chop vegetables when I'm making Manchurian fried rice. This is all rounder. This is a very small appliance and would hardly take up any space in your kitchen. It actually comes with a wall hanging attachment, and you can actually free up your space, counter space in the kitchen, and hang it onto the wall. It's very affordable, very easy to clean, and I highly recommend it. Next up is this Nutri Ninja Duo. It comes with a blender and a food processor and travel mug as well. Blenders are an important appliance for those who need to mix sauces, juices, or soups. Not to be confused with food processors, a blender's main benefit is its ability to blend two or more liquids together. Its motor is generally less powerful than that of a food processor, and its blades are less sharp. So a blender is better used with liquids and ice. I personally use blender to make pani puri pani, blend onion tomato gravy to make Punjabi curries. It perfectly and evenly blends gravy for me when I'm making delicious paneer butter masala or any given Punjabi gravy. Nutri Ninja comes with this travel cup in which you can make smoothies and replace the blades with travel lid, and off you go to work. So convenient. These cups comes in various sizes and can absolutely be used for anything, like finely crushing rotis or bhakris to make laddus, finely crushing masalas if you prefer homemade spices. Food processor is used to blend semi-solid foods like making hummus, almond meal, or even make the dough using dough blade. All you need is 2 cups of flour, 1 cup water, and a teaspoon of oil. Blend in food processor on low or pulse function and perfectly kneaded dough comes out. So whether you have to make cookie dough or roti dough in seconds, Nutri Ninja processor is your friend. If you need to quickly chop vegetables to make a salad, a food processor is your best friend. Pulse function of food processor is best suitable to roughly chop vegetables to make kachori cucumber salad. Nutri Ninja will certainly do most of your jobs in the kitchen, and it's super easy to clean as well. Travel cup blades are easiest to clean as the blades are easily accessible. For blender and food processor, simply pulse some warm water and a couple of drops of soap for a quick cleanup. The third appliance that I absolutely love and I use it almost every other day is sandwich press or sandwich griller. It not only makes cafe style grilled sandwiches of your choice, but also can be used to make burgers. Its temperature control and auto on off gives perfect heat to toast the burger and do not burn them. You can grill vegetables and make mouth-watering grilled veggie toast. Lastly, you can toast wraps in this too. All you have to do is buy pita bread from store, cut just a quarter of it exactly this way, fill toppings of your choice. I love the combination of avocado, veggies, cheese. Fold it in quarter and toast it in sandwich press and your filling and mouth-watering meal is ready in no time. So if you're a busy working mom, this is the appliance that you need. You can make not only healthy and yummy sandwiches, but also wraps, burgers for weeknight dinners for your family. So next must-have kitchen appliance, if you love pizzas, is this pizza maker. I have been using this pizza maker since a decade now. Yes, you heard it right. I am using it for over 10 years now and it's still going great. Its stone plate is completely stained, but it's perfectly normal, and since it has been in use since so many years, it's been inevitable. To clean the stone, once the stone has completely cooled off, scrape off any baked on food with a scraper. I personally like to use pizza scraper and then use a damp cloth to wipe it down. And let me tell you guys, if you own one of these at home, you will simply forget Domino's and Pizza Hut these pizzas, as you can make ethnic traditional Italian style pizzas, restaurant style pizzas at your home. Last appliance is this bread toaster. It can be used not only to perfectly brown your different styles of bread, but also to make tandoori butter rotis. Yes, you heard it right. I'll show you how I do it. Most of the toasters comes in with time setting that controls browning of bread. A multigrain bread will take longer to toast than a raisin toast. So this function is very helpful. So all I would do is I would bind the roti dough just as normal, make roti but in the shape of an oval so that I can put it into the toaster, and before putting it into the toaster I will slightly roast it onto the gas so that it holds its shape, and then voila, you put it into the toaster maybe on 2 setting, and then you will get perfectly puffed tandoori roti, and you can apply butter on top of it and it tastes yum. It tastes like as if it was made in tandoori oven. So guys, be creative and find multiple uses of your kitchen appliances and use them to their fullest capacity. So this is all I have in terms of small kitchen appliances that I absolutely swear by. So hand blender, toaster, pizza maker, Nutri Ninja, and my bread toaster. I do have other appliances like an ice cream maker or a citrus juicer, but these I wouldn't categorize as essential kitchen appliances. These definitely are. I know people swear by their rice cooker, slow cooker, their juicers. There's so many appliances out there, but this will do 99% most of the jobs of your kitchen. If you enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to like this video. Each like matters. So do your bit, guys, and I shall see you in my next video. Bye for now.